Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about opening balance and closing balance DAX functions. These two functions are very important when you are dealing with accounts and balances or in case of stock reports. You want to consolidate at the end of the month what is your stock at the closing balance level. I mean to say end of the month stock, right? How many quantities? So let's try to understand what is the problem we encounter in the typical conventional functions if we use sum or sum x, and how we can address this using this opening and closing balance functions. And these functions are also categorized as semi-additive measures. I will also talk about it little later once we understand these two functions. What do you mean by semi-additive measures? With this note, let's begin our today's topic. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So I'm in Power BI now. Let's try to understand the data set and existing problem. Then we will move on to how we can use this opening and closing balance function. So to understand the data, let's see what it is. I have a simple data set, just say like for each day you have a product and what is the stock. So this will be updated based on how much it is purchased or how much it is sold. So consider on first it is 128 stock and one can be sold, so it becomes 127. Then next day some of them more are or quantities sold, so you have 103. You see on this day it is increased, maybe the purchases happen, so it is the end of the day stock. So on each day level for each product you have a sum stock quantity. Let's go on to Power BI. This is the data set, simple data set. Now I'm not bringing anything into picture about the product or in the stock table. I have a date and product, okay, there's two, and stock. These are three columns. I'm not bringing the product dimension anywhere here, just we will try to understand with the date. So for each date I am analyzing this stock, okay. So when you analyze these stocks at the day level, everything looks fine. But when you say on February 1st, what is my stock as on end of month stock, right? When you bring the month dimension, when you want to see at the month level, right, you see this is like a balance. You are assume your bank balance, okay, for each day you have a bank balance entry, right? At the end of the month it should be like it is the same balance as on that last day of the month, right? That is your bank balance. You should not sum it up. By default, what is the behavior of Power BI? If you drag and drop some measure, you can see here for January each day it is the balance, right? But January, what happens for each day it is summing up. When you see here, let's filter January here, this is the total, right? 6237, that is what it is showing. Basically for this kind of stock analysis, for a measure identified, that stock should not be summed up. That is the problem statement. How we are going to address this? So for me, at the January level, month level, when I see it, I should see the closing balance as 223. So Power BI in DAX, we have a default function called closing balance. Let's try to see that. So closing balance of stock, let's say stock. So the function is closing balance month, okay, I'm using the month. There are other functions called quarter and year. Now let's try to understand this closing balance month. What I want to do the closing balance, I want to do the closing balance by sum of stock. I will tell you why I put sum here. And then dim date dot date, across dim date I want to do this closing balance calculation. So when I drag and drop this closing balance measure here, now you can see for January 223 is my closing balance. I got the desired result. Same thing will applicable when you go to February. When you see 2020 quarter, February 29, 196, that is what it will show it to me now. So this is how we can easily get rid of this problem. You cannot sum this particular measure, right? This is what you call the definition as. You cannot sum this measure, the stock, by this dimension. That is what closing balance end of month. So if you want to see at the quarterly balance, what is this quarter? Let's say March 2020 quarter 1, 31st, right? 155 you want to see across these 3 months. Okay, this is the end of month balance. But if you want to see the quarter level balance, you can write a measure. Let's quickly write that measure so that you will understand. Closing balance. Closing balance. Bear with me. Closing balance. Quarter. Okay. The function is nothing but closing balance quarter. And what you want to do is sum of the stock dot stock dim date dot date. That's it. So now you can note down this March 31st is 155. You can see it for this January, February, March closing balance stock for the quarter. There you go. 155 is repeated for this quarter. So this is how it is very simple to calculate the closing balance. So this is same applicable for the opening balance, but the slight differences between the opening balance and closing balance is like opening balance is always 1 day prior to that date. What I'm saying, let's get rid of this closing balance now. Now you clear with closing balance. Let's have opening balance. So you can see here the opening balance. Come on. What happened? Okay. You can see from here the opening balance of January is empty because the opening balance of January is nothing but the previous day, December 2019, 31st data. There is no data at all. That's why it's blank. Now for February, it is January's January 31st closing balance. The opening balance of any day is the closing balance of previous day. So that is what it is. So for February, it is 223. So you no need to think about it. Those who are learning or knowing this is the opening or closing balance, for them it is new. Those who are already aware, just use this opening balance of month, opening balance or closing balance of month if you want at the month level. Then you can use either quarter or month year as well. There is three functions available for opening balance and closing balance. You see quarter as well as year. There are three functions for this. Now coming to subject, like as I said, semi additive measure. What do you mean by that? Basically, as I said, when you say you are saying sum of stock and you are saying the closing balance of, you mentioned some date, right? Which is meaning like you do not sum all these stock items for every day for this opening balance measure, that stock measure. Instead you show the last value. But for the product, right, this product, there are two products in this particular analysis, right? Let's say for this product, the opening balance, right, the opening balance means we'll go for a check for January 31st, 142, and for the formal it is 81. So 142 plus 81 is 223. That is what it is showing. So the semi additive measure means don't sum this for your date dimension, but sum it for across all other dimension. That is what the semi additive definition is. Basically, you don't sum your measure, whatever in the focus, that stock is in our focus, don't sum it across the date. You sum it across other dimension. That is what the semi-additive measures definition is. So this is what is all about the opening balance and closing balance. This is also called as semi-additive measures in DAX. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.